Not everybody can afford to hire a private criminal defense attorney, so I thought I'd make a video about how to get the best representation out of your public defender. The biggest complaint people have when they hire me after having a bad experience with a public defender is lack of communication. The reality is that not everybody has the financial wherewithal to hire a private criminal defense attorney. So I thought, even though I'm not a public defender, I'd give some advice to people who are in that position. How do you get the best representation from your court-appointed lawyer? Well, look, communication is key. I suggest that you communicate early and often with your public defender. You should send emails so you have a track record of what you've communicated. When can you expect a check-in from the lawyer? What information would they like from you? When are they going to schedule the next court date? Are they looking into a motion to dismiss or a motion to suppress? If not, why not? You should always ask for a copy of your criminal complaint, docket, and police report. If there's anything else that's turned over, any other evidence, you should ask for a copy of that too. Or if it's not feasible, or if there's a protective order, you should ask to see it in your attorney's office. It makes sense because you know the facts better than anybody else. Your lawyer may know the law, but you know the facts, so you should have access to everything that your attorney has so that you can help in your own defense. If you have helpful witnesses, you should tell your attorney. You should give the attorney the names and contact information and explain why that witness may be helpful to your case. If you have evidence that you think is helpful to the case, make sure to get it to your attorney early. They may have obligations to turn it over to the prosecutor or to notify the court that they have evidence to turn over. It's called reciprocal discovery. If you have text message evidence, for instance, ask your lawyer what format they'd like it in. For instance, when I'm working with a client, I want them to extract it. I can recommend programs for people to extract their text messages. I don't want 50 screenshots in 50 separate emails to my email and try to put them together. It doesn't make sense, and it's not the best way to present evidence in court. So ask your lawyer how they want the evidence. Tell them what you have and tell them how you think it's helpful to your case. And then ask them what's the best format to get it to you. If you have evidence that you think is helpful but you don't have copies of, like phone records, tell your lawyer. Tell your lawyer your phone company. Tell your lawyer what exactly you think is going to be helpful. And then ask your lawyer what they need from you in order to get those records. And in the end, it comes down to good communication. You have good communication with your lawyer. If your lawyer reaches out to you and asks you for something, then get back to them in a reasonable amount of time. Or if it's going to take you a while, tell them it's going to take you a while. Tell them why. Make sure you show up to appointments with your lawyer. Make sure you communicate with your lawyer regularly. And if you get a lawyer who's not responsive, follow up an email, follow up with a certified letter. And at the last resort, if the lawyer's still not communicating with you and you're not in a position to hire somebody, you can go to court at the next date. Have a list of all the times you've tried to communicate with your lawyer and ask for a new lawyer to be assigned.